गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन। तो एम आई ऑडिबल टू एवरीवन?
गुड आफ्टरनून सर।
सो वी हैड लास्ट क्लास यस्टरडे। Okay, then let us start. So in the last class, we did till this. The last was the chemical problem, I think. This one. Okay, so this was the thing now we have done till this. Yes or no? Do you remember?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so let us continue from here. All of you can see the screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so now I will start today. Like, you know, you might be knowing, I think, already. So what is the definition of cake already? K-coloring graph. या के प्रॉपर कलरिंग है ना, प्रॉपर के कलरिंग, दे आर रिलेटेड थिंग, प्रॉपर के कलरिंग। सो हाउ वी डिफाइन दिस, आई विल राइट द डेफिनेशन। या एनीवन वुड लाइक टू टेल? Have you gone through this or is it new to you? Okay, so remembering will take this much time. Yes or no? I mean, have you done this earlier or this is new to you? I mean, are you familiar or not? Not able to decide or what? I'm talking about these words: K coloring, K colorable graphs, proper K coloring. So all these are related things. So is it known to you or is it new?
Sir, known.
Yes. So then tell me, please tell me the definition. Anyone?
K coloring is the proper of adjacent vertices have different labels or colors.
Okay, this is proper K coloring, yes. Yeah, okay. So let me write it. So K coloring means you want to color the graph of by K different color. And K colorable graph, so first this word comes before K colorable. So we call K coloring is proper if you have a different color to the adjacent vertices. And then we call the graph is K coloring. So So let me write it clearly. So like k coloring of a graph G is a actually labeling. So labeling function, you can say, that goes from vertex set to S, where cardinality of set S is k. Okay, so it means you color the vertices, all the vertices, by k different colors. They mean that. Okay, and the labels are actually, so the label, I'm using the word, so this labels are actually colors. Okay, and the vertices, like the vertices of one color, the vertices of one color form a color class. Vertices of one color forms a color class. So you know, color class means collection of all vertices of same color. Like you talk about red, suppose in particularly we color few vertices by red, or we label by one. So all the vertices labeled by one will form a set, and that set will call a color class. Okay, so a k coloring is called proper. So this will be proper. So k coloring will be proper if adjacent vertices have different levels or different colors. Different levels. Okay. Different levels. Or you can say different colors. So we call k coloring graph is proper if adjacent vertices have different colors. Now we define k colorable graph. So a graph G is k colorable if it has
proper k color.
Right, it has a proper k coloring. So k coloring means you want to just color the vertices with k different colors. There is no condition. K colorable means you have to consider the fact that adjacent vertices must have a different color. So a graph G is k-colorable if it has a proper k-coloring. Okay. So like the chromatic number, you know. So anyone would like to repeat the definition of chromatic number? Anyone tell me what is definition of chromatic number? Because this is important. This word will come eventually. Yeah. What is the chromatic
number? Chromatic number is the minimum value of K, so that K is a colorable.
Yes, that will work. Or original definition, if you remember, so that was minimum number of colors required to label the vertices, so that adjacent vertices have different color. Yeah, same thing. So the chromatic number actually notation is chi G. So this is the list K. Okay, this is a list K such that G is k colorable, what you told. So you are also right. G is k colorable. So it is list number k. Okay. So what is the value of k for which it is k colorable?
So
3. Yes. So like chromatic number of G, if you find, so this will be 3. Na? So 1, you can say 2, then this. You can say this, right? And you have to take some third color here. Okay. So this is 3 colorable. And what about this one? What is the value of k? What is it? Is k colorable?
Two.
Yes, so it is 2. So we can color this with the 3. And so it is 2 colorable, right? So chromatic number of G here is 2, and it is 2 colorable. So in a proper coloring, okay, you can see the one thing, like if you collect, suppose I say A, B, C, D, E, F. So collect the vertices with the same color, like A, C, and E. So what do you say this set? This set is? What is the name of this set? A, C, E. Or we can say the other one. Like B, D, F. So these vertices forms what?
Independent set.
Yes. So set containing BDF, matlab vertices of the same color. So you have seen one definition, color class. So here you collect the vertices with same color in K colorable graph. So it will form in proper coloring, it will form an independent set. So these are independent set. So independent set, you know, it's a collection of non-adjacent, pairwise non-adjacent vertices. So you can color two vertices with same color only if they are non-adjacent. No? Otherwise, adjacent will have different color. Non-adjacent may have same color. Okay, so only same, if you collect all the vertices with same color, so they will form an independent set. So that's what I'm writing. So in a proper coloring, each color class is an independent set. Okay, in a proper coloring, each color class is an independent set. So you can also say like graph G is K colorable. So graph G is K colorable if and only if. Okay, in proper coloring, each color class is independent set. Okay, so a K colorable graph, you know, it has a K proper coloring. So G is K colorable if and only if the vertex set denoted by V of G, vertex set of G, is the union of K independent sets, right? So G is K colorable if and only if the vertex set is the union of K independent sets. And you know, what is the name of this definition? So, okay, what do you know about k-partite graph? You know k-partite graph or bipartite graph, bipartite for 2 and k-partite, you can take any k. So what is the definition of k-partite graph? How do you define k-partite graph? No one knows? what I'm asking? K partite graph. You all know. Because then we will establish a relation between K partite graph and K colorable graph. So if you know both things, then it's very easy to make you understand. So like we have written here, G is K colorable if and only if the vertex set is the union of K independent set. And yes.
Sir, K partite graph is a graph whose vertices can be partitioned into K different independent set.
Right. So like G is K partite. I'm just repeating, this is, you know, K partite if vertex set can be written as union of K independent set. Okay, and look the here what I written here. So G is K colorable if and only if vertex set is the union of K independent set. So what can you conclude from these two things? See, G is K colorable if and only if the vertex set is the union of K independent set. And the definition of K partite graph is also same. G is K partite if and only, you can also write if and only if here, no problem. If and only if vertex set of G can be written as union of K independent set. So what is the relation between K colorable and K partite graph? So both are the same. So I mean that, hence you can say, or therefore you can say, K partite graph and like you want to say K colorable graph, both are same thing, okay, have same meaning. So both have the same meaning. So both have same meaning. So K partite graph you say, or it is K colorable graph, both are the same. So K partite or K colorable, K partite, okay, have the same meaning. Okay, so you can simply see here, I made one example. So like here, if you'd like to write, so simply you can say it is two partite, or two colorable, you can also say two partite, you can say bipartite. So means vertex set can be written as a union of two independent sets. And you know, there are two different colors. So obviously vertex set can be written as union of two independent set. Both sets consist of same colors, like A, C, E is one color and other will be B, B, D, F. Yes, B, D. So they are independent set, both are. And we can write union of two independent set means is bipartite. So it is two colorable, you can say two bipartite. Same here, see that. So what can I write vertex set? So let me name it A, B, C, D, E. Okay. So vertex set can be written as union of how many independent sets? At least how many independent sets?
Three independent set.
Yes, three independent set. That will be like, so we can make one set of same color, like A, C have the same color, then B, D have the same
B,
color.
D.
Yes, and E alone. So there are three independent sets. So you can say it is three colorable, or you can say it is three partite. Same thing. Three partite. So this graph is three partite, three colorable. Okay. Okay, so now let's start with the topic. So I think you were doing this already. So topic is vertex coloring and upper bound. So you already have the lower bounds. Do we have lower bounds already? We have established, or do we do? Okay. So vertex colored and upper bounds. So in this we'll see k chromatic graphs and we'll see color critical graph, or you can say or k critical graphs, and then we'll see click number of a graph and independent number of graphs. Okay, then we will also see like upper bound for first, lower bound for this chromatic number of Z, and upper bound for chromatic number of Z. So we'll see this. So first start with the K chromatic graph. Okay, yeah, so anyone would like to define K chromatic graph? Name itself says the definition. So what I'm saying, K chromatic graph, yeah, what is the definition of this? You read the definition, you read the word twice, you will get the definition. What is the K chromatic graph? अरे भाई सबको पता है तुम लोगों को, टेल मी.
ग्राफ हैविंग क्रोमेटिक नंबर के.
यस, नेम इटसेल्फ सेज के क्रोमेटिक ग्राफ मींस अ ग्राफ लेट से जी इज के क्रोमेटिक ग्राफ इफ क्रोमेटिक नंबर ऑफ ग्राफ जी इज गोइंग टू बी के. सिंपल. Okay, so a graph is k chromatic graph if chromatic number of graph is k. Simple. So only this is important. Okay, chromatic number is k. So a proper k coloring of a k colorable graph is an optimal coloring. Okay, so mainly I want to define now k critical graph. So what is k critical graph? So suppose if chromatic number of H is less than chromatic number of G, so H is the subgraph of G, proper subgraph. So H is the proper subgraph of G. So chromatic number of H is less than this, or suppose chromatic number of G is K. So if chromatic number of H is less than chromatic number of G, for every proper subgraph H of G, then G is called color critical or K critical. Okay, so read the definition carefully. So if every subgraph has a less chromatic number than the original graph, chromatic number of original graph, then we call that graph is the K critical. Okay, so if it's, for example, if I ask you, so look this graph, this is K2. So is it color critical? Yes or no? Think and tell. So is it color critical? Read definition and try to fit on this. What are you thinking?
No, sir, it is no critical.
Okay, no critical. Why? So, if you say it is not color critical, then you have to tell me one subgraph that has the critical number equal to graph. I mean, chromatic number equal to graph. Like suppose I write subgraph, this is a graph, so let me write subgraph, proper subgraph actually. Who like to write proper subgraphs? So what will be proper subgraphs? H1 you can write like single vertex, or H2 you can write two vertex without edge. Okay, there are two subgraphs I can see, proper subgraphs. Okay, so first of all, what is chromatic number of K2?
Two,
because you will need at least two different color to label, right? So two different color you give them. Okay, and so this is two. What is chromatic number of H1?
One, sir.
One. What is chromatic number of H2?
One.
It is again one, because there is no edge, so you can color with the same color. So do you see, every proper subgraph has less chromatic number than the graph? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So answer is K2 is color critical or two critical, or you can say K2 is two critical. Two, why? Two is the chromatic number of K2. That's why. Okay. Okay. Let me write one more example. So suppose, I think about this, K3 I take. So do you see this K3 is going to be color critical? Everyone please check whether it is color critical. So what is the, you see all the subgraphs, proper subgraphs, and if all the subgraphs has the less chromatic number than the chromatic number of the graph, then you say it is a color critical or K critical. So chromatic number of K3 you already know, you need at least three color, I mean three, and then okay, so you say it is a color critical. Yes, so answer is correct. It will be, you write any subgraphs, like proper subgraph, I may write this is a 1, suppose I say it H1, without any edge all 3, or you can say only 2, you join it, this is 1, or maybe this like this, so this is H2, this is H3, or maybe you can write like this, this is H4. You can write more, okay? So these are the subgraphs, proper subgraph, okay? So you have to remove at least one edge or at least one vertex to get proper subgraph. Okay, means you can single vertex you can also write, or so some more you can write. Single vertex you can write, or you can write double vertex like this H5, or you can write single vertex H6. That are also subgraphs. So you see, your chromatic number you can see. So for H6, chromatic number is 1. For H5, it is again 1. For H4, what is chromatic number?
The 2.
It is 2. And chromatic number of H3, again 2.
2, sir.
Okay. So chromatic number of H2 will also be 2, and chromatic number of H1 will be 1, because there is no edge between vertices. So what do you see here? All the proper subgraph has the less chromatic number than the chromatic number of the original graph. So means again K3 is color critical, or K critical. K is 3 here, 3 critical. Okay. Fine. So if you have any doubt, you can ask. So two colorable, you have seen one thing, like we have seen like K partite. Is same as K colorable, so due to which you can say bipartite is same as 2 colorable. Okay, similarly you can also write tripartite is same as 3 colorable. Okay, if I write this, is it K critical or color critical? So look at this. Yes. So can you say this as a color critical? I'm writing one more example. So you know it's a cycle of size 4. So it has 4 vertices. So chromatic number of C4 is
2.
2, yes. So one color you can take here, one color you can take here, and other color you can take here and here. Okay, so two different colors required to label. So chromatic number is 2, yes. Okay, so check if all the proper subgraph has a less chromatic number. So like if I write one subgraph, so suppose this one, you take only this. So we removed one edge, okay? This is a proper subgraph. So what is the chromatic number of this H1?
Two, sir.
Yes. So you can take this, and you can take here this color, then this color. So again here is it is 2. So you can see here, okay, graph and subgraph, proper subgraph have same, but according to definition of K critical graph, proper subgraph must have the less chromatic number than the graph. So here it is not. So you can say C4 is not color critical or K critical. K is 4, sorry, 2 here. Chromatic number is 2, so 2 critical. So this C4 is not. Why? Because you can write also, because this H1 proper subgraph has the same chromatic number as the C4, but according to definition that must be less than, okay. What about this cycle of size 5, order 5? C5, and you know it is odd cycle.
Chromatic number 3,
sir.
Yes, 3. And is it color critical? So you write any subgraph and see, and we write all the subgraph and see whether any subgraph will have the less chromatic number than this.
Subgraph will also have, sir, 3.
So which subgraph you want to take? So take in, there might be many subgraphs, okay, proper subgraphs, but we want to take one proper subgraph. So which edge or which vertex you want to remove? Because to get proper subgraph you have to remove
A.
Okay, A you remove. So when you remove A, then two A's will also remove with it. So you want to take this, because when you remove A, then there will be no case of edges. Okay, so this is your H1, I mean first proper subgraph. So you know chromatic number of H1.
Two, sir.
Yes, so it is 2. So you can see chromatic number of H1 is less than C5. So this example says it is color chromatic, color critical, C5. In fact, you take any subgraph, this will have. The answer is yes, means C5 is color critical, but C4 was not. Okay. Or you can say it is a 3 critical, right? 3 critical. In fact, the result is, let me write the result. The 3 critical graphs are actually the odd cycles. Okay, cycle of size, or like you can say 3 cycles, C3, C5, C7, that will be 3 critical graphs. Or color critical, you can say. Okay. Now, let me give you a few questions to find the chromatic number. So let me make a graph. So suppose this. This one. Like we have here, Okay, so this has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 vertices. Okay. So question is, find the chromatic number of this graph. So now question is, suppose I say graph G. So first question is, find the chromatic number of graph G. Okay, let me give you one more. This one is also done. Okay. Yeah. Now you find. So you have to think minimum number of color required to level the vertices so that adjacent vertices have different colors.
Four, sir.
Okay, so for you it is four. Yeah, for others. Four. Yeah. Anyone else is trying? So since there are many triangles inside this graph, you can see many triangles, obviously more than 3 or more than 3, at least 3 will be the chromatic number because there are many triangles, you know. So triangles means this triangle is a proper subgraph. So this triangle has at least 3 chromatic numbers, so at least 3 will be, so maybe 3 or more than 3. So anyone else is trying?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Do it and tell me. Is it 4 your also answer or something different?
Six, sir.
Okay. 11, 6. So you have to remember, you have to minimize the colors. Okay. So take the minimum color to level vertices. Okay, then let me try. So see, you start coloring. Suppose I say first color here, okay? So you know, on any, you can start with anywhere. If you want, we can start with here also at the bottom. So suppose I give first color here, 1. So you know, at the triangle, you have to give the different color, because in triangle, each vertex is the adjacent to the other. So 1, let's say it is 2, 3, or if you want, then I can color it like I give this color to this vertex, suppose, and red to this, keep it white. So suppose white to this. So 3 color I use for this triangle. Okay, now you come to the adjacent triangle, so like right side triangle. So here again, you can give here any color which one you want. Red you can give, so give the red color to it. And then here you have to give this color then. Okay, and here you can give white. So just make sure adjacent vertices have different colors. Okay, and here you can not give white, then this is a problem. 1 minute. So if you give white, then you cannot give white here. So you have to. Okay, here let me give it white. Okay, so I have to give red here, right? Can we give? Because if you take in place, we're using this color, so this color I'm giving. So why? Because this has to be different, right? So if I take white there, okay. Now come to the top circle, top triangle, triangle at the top. So here you can give this. And you can give white here, then you have to give, suppose you get give white here, red you can also give, then you have to give white here. Yes. So in the triangle, all three vertices must have different color. So that's what I'm doing. Is it fine? So do you see any adjacent vertices have same color? All are different. So if I label it like if you want name, so I can have 1. So red are 1, suppose 1. This is 1. You can label like this. And this are 2. So 2. This is 2. And white is 3. So this is 3, 3, 3. So how many colors I used? Only 3. So answer is 3. Okay. So answer is 3. Okay. Suppose you don't. Other one you can think. So you can write like. Suppose you start since triangle is as proper subgraph of G. Then you know chromatic number of G going to be more than equal to 3. Either 3 or more than equal to 3. And we use the color and so we use the color only 3 color, right? So and 3 coloring of the graph of the vertices you can say, or of the graph, 3 coloring of the graph says, like implies, you can say chromatic number of G is less than equal to 3. So we have used 3 color to chromatic, like you have used, so you told 4 because you used 4 color. So but maybe less than equal to 4, somewhere use 6, right? So 6 color you use, so means chromatic number may be less than equal to 6. So you have to make sure, is it minimum? So you have to check. Like I use 3 colors, so can it be minimized? No, I know it cannot be minimized because in triangle you need at least 3 colors. So that's why this was the correct answer. So if you use, suppose in coloring of graph, if you use 3 colors, then maybe it have a chromatic number less than equal to 3, because chromatic number is minimum color, so you might be using more colors. Okay, so from here you can decide, okay, this and this implies chromatic number of G is going to be 3, or simply you are confident, then you can simply do carefully. Okay, so this was, try one more. So I think you will, this time you will be able to do. So the graph is okay, so this has how many vertices? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, let me name it A, B, C, D, E, F, suppose. Yeah. So you try and tell me the chromatic number of this graph. So everyone please try, okay?
So 3.
Okay, 3. Yeah, anyone getting different answer? Suppose I start leveling, suppose I give this color to A. Then you know A is adjacent to B and E. So B and E must have the different color. But C you can give the same color. Or like F you can give the same color. A and F are non-adjacent, right? Now B has to have this different color than A and F. Obviously, let's say E. And now, okay, so problem is now C and D you cannot give the same color. So see, I did one mistake. So I would give the red color to this. So will not be any problem. So in that case, C and E are not adjacent. So we can give the third color like this. So now, because in a triangle, you must have the three different colors. So C there. So you can label it like 1, 1, first color, and 2, 2. 3, 3. So 3 color required. So here again you can see this is a triangle inside as a proper subgraph. So you can like, since G has a triangle as a proper subgraph. Proper subgraph. So this implies chromatic number of G will be more than equal to 3, because triangle will require at least 3 different colors. Also, what we did 3 coloring. So we use 3 color to level the vertices. So 3 coloring of graph implies chromatic number of C will be less than equal to 3. But we use actually 3 color to level vertices. So chromatic number will be 3 or less than equal to 3. Or you are sure it is minimum, then that's fine. So therefore you can say chromatic number of G is going to be 3 only. Or directly you can write 3, no problem. If you don't write this, you can see, because minimum number of color required is 3, that's fine. But this logic you can keep. Okay, so if I give you one more problem then. So the next graph is, the triangle, another triangle. Let me make one. This is a graph, and there is a vertex at the center also. So you join this, this, and this. You join these two vertex, and you join these two vertex. These two vertex are joined. These two are joined. This is joined with this. Okay. So vertices are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yes. So what will be chromatic number of this graph?
सर फोर
ओके फोर
यस सर फोर
सो वन थिंग यू कैन डिसाइड सो यू कैन लुक एट द दिस सेंटर देयर इज अ कंप्लीट ग्राफ ऑफ ऑर्डर फोर राइट सो कंप्लीट ग्राफ ऑफ ऑर्डर फोर मीन्स सिंस G contains K4 as proper subgraph. Therefore, you are sure that chromatic number of G is equal to 4. Now, is it minimum? So, let's try to level it using 4 colors only. Okay. So, give it to other color okay so now suppose I start with I give this color to this okay same then other you have to give four different color to the K4 you know in complete graph all vertices must have the different color so all vertices must have the different color right so different color Now you can just arrange them. So you can see outside triangle. So suppose I give them a red color. Suppose. So like I give it a red. Okay. So there I can give this color. And you make sure adjacent vertices have different color. Okay. So I can give it here. Fine. And then other one like you can do. You can give white here. Or. So here you can give this one fine and then a red one here so the triangle will have three different color okay so you need only four colored so again you can see four coloring of graph says implies chromatic number will be more than equal to 4 so by this one and by this one you can say chromatic number are exactly 4 okay so you can find I think chromatic number of any graph now you got the concept and you know I think already so next time I will start with like there is a you know this yes. notation n of g means what and this you know so next time we'll introduce two more notation omega of g and alpha of g do you know these notations
yes sir
n of g means
number of vertices in graph g
yes so order of graph we say not degree order okay degree is something else we'll see this you know chromatic number What is this omega g?
Click number.
Yes. Click number. And this is alpha g.
Independent number.
Independent.
Independent.
So I would say you in last three graph. You can also try to find this click number is the maximum size of the click in the graph and independent number is the maximum size of independent set in the graph and chromatic number you know the minimum color minimum number of color required to level the vertices and order of graph is the number of vertices so in all three graphs which we have find chromatic number you can also find these things so in next class I will continue with this okay so any question to anyone Anyone would like to ask me any questions?